From the people who brought you Ultimate Werewolf, Werewords, and One Night Ultimate Werewolf, comes a game of deception, accusations, and terrifying creatures that anyone can play.
Wait, hold on. We can't do another werewolf game.
Well,
just tell me it doesn't have any werewolves in it.
But it does have a werewolf.
But what else does it have?
A were-ghost, a were-zombie, and a were-blob.
Well, it can't get any weirder than that.
Challenge accepted. How about a were-clown?
Oh, that's creepy.
A were-kitten?
Well, that's different.
Not as different as a were-nana.
That makes absolutely no sense.
Then you'll really be confused about the were-bago.
Okay, enough. What do you do in the game?
Players secretly collect different were-beasts. The more were-beasts you collect that match your hidden goals, the better. Unless someone figures out what you're collecting.
I like were-beasts because it's fast-paced, and it's a fun game of, you know, trying to figure out who's collecting what.
I don't think were-beasts is like any game that I've really played before. Werebeast is definitely a game I'd be bringing to my gaming table.
So you're able to kind of pick up on other people's strategies quickly. It's the challenge of getting to guess what cards people have.
I like Werebeasts because I'm a big fan of social deception games, and this one is one that is much different than anyone I've played before.
You can have multiple ways of accomplishing your goal. If you want to play deceptively, or if you want to play honestly and hope that throws people off because it's kind of a deception game.
Werebeasts is fast and innovative, and there is very little downtime. It's easy to play, it's great for a group of people, and I would highly recommend it to anyone.
Werebeasts is for 3 to 10 players, takes 20 minutes to play, and will be on Kickstarter September 5th with exclusive Werebeasts.
Well, looks like we've finally jumped the proverbial were-shark.
Done!
Great. At least save something for the sequel.
Too late.